Welcome to the Maker's Pet Robot 3D Printing Instructions video. In this video, we will go over the robot body parts, learn how to configure the 3D printing slicer software, and 3D print the robot parts. Once finished, this home robot will act as a pet, look cute, play ball, hide and seek and chase, entertain the owner, keep company, demand attention, and patrol the house. First, let's download the files for 3D printing. Open your browser and navigate to the Maker's Pet robot model repository on GitHub. Click the green code button and click the download zip button to download the robot's source code. I'm downloading the Maker's Pet Loki robot design files, but you can also 3D print the bigger robots named Fido and Snoopy. Open the downloaded zip file, drag the 3MF or STL folder to your desktop, and open that folder. Launch your slicer software. I'm using a Prusa slicer, however, your slicer should have similar setting. Drag and drop the bottom plate file into your slicer. I recommend printing all robot's parts using PLA or PETG filament, using 0.2 mm layer height. Unless I mention specifically otherwise, please use the default slicer settings, that is no brim and no support. Let's start from the bottom plate. Slicing and 3D printing the bottom plate is pretty straightforward. Just use the default slicer settings, that is no supports and no brim. Place the motor bracket upside down as shown. You will need two of those motor brackets. Slice and print those using the default setting. The caster wheel model comes with a pedestal to simplify its printing. Place the caster wheel on its pedestal, go to your slicer's print settings and set the seam location to random. Otherwise, slice and print the caster wheel using the default settings, that is no supports and no brim. Remove the caster wheel off the build plate and carefully break the plastic pedestal off like this. When the seam location is not set to random, the caster wheel gets a seam like this. The seam, both on the inside and the outside, causes the wheel to make a loud knocking sound as the robot rolls over a hardwood floor. Let's reset the seam location setting before we move on. The battery pedestal, the battery enclosure, and the battery enclosure lid, just place those as shown. The battery enclosure lid has a tiny notch. Make sure that notch goes on top. Slice and print those three parts using the default settings. The middle plate is pretty straightforward. Slice it and print it using the default settings. Same goes for the laser distance sensor mounting plate. Slice it and print it using the default settings. Place the bumpers upside down and enable the brim setting in your slicer. I print the bumpers using a silk PLA to get a glossy look. If you want to have a glossy look like this, make sure to use 0.2 mm or bigger layer height. When I tried printing silk PLA using thinner layers, that glossy look disappeared. The upper plate is quite straightforward. Slice it and print it using the default settings. Place the robot's head face down on the build plate and enable the supports. Just like the bumpers, I printed the robot's head using a silk PLA filament. If you want to keep the glossy look, just keep the layer height at 0.2 mm. This is my default. If you care more about the print quality, consider reducing the layer height. Lastly, place the handset footrest on the build plate vertically and place the handset's upper clamp on its tab like this. Enable the supports. Great! Now that we have all the robot's parts, we can proceed with the assembly as explained in the next video.